Variable data printing, VDP, is a digital printing technique that enables customization within a single print run by altering specific elements like text, images, or graphics based on individual data entries. This technology is commonly used for creating personalized marketing materials, such as direct mail, postcards, or brochures, where each printed piece can be customized for the recipient. VDP is popular in industries where targeted, personalized communication is essential, as it enhances engagement by tailoring messages to the recipient's interests, demographics, or past behaviors. VDP leverages databases and digital printing, making it both efficient and scalable, which sets it apart from traditional printing methods that require separate setups for each version. What are the basic building blocks of a variable print job? First, we need a basic layout, designed with placeholders, data fields, for the variable elements. This layout defines the static, unchanging elements, like background, logos, and general imagery, and provides designated areas for the variable content. We next need a database of variable information, a structured database, Excel, CSV, or SQL, containing the personalized data for each recipient. This includes elements like names, addresses, demographic information, purchase history, lists of numbers for labeling or barcodes, or any other specific data you want to personalize in the print. If we are creating ID cards, for example, we will also need personalized images based on the recipient's profile or company preferences. If we are intending to create labels with barcodes, then we will need to install barcode fonts, as these will be used to convert lists of numbers from a data source into barcodes. Next on the list is VDP software, or RIP software, capable of merging the database with the template. Some common options include VDP plugins or proprietary software, such as Roland VersaWorks, Mamaki's Finecut, or other software that can facilitate a dynamic data insertion for each print job and manage the creation of unique outputs. Finally, we need a digital printer capable of processing variable data jobs and handling continuous unique outputs, without requiring a new setup for each print. Step 1. Creating the basic design. Start by creating a basic design. Be aware of leaving enough space for the data fields. Although most software RIPs have the option of automatically resizing text to fit a data field, leaving enough space for the fields ensures that fonts won't have to be shrunk too much to fit the space allotted. Each data field must have an outline that is treated as a spot and not a process color. In a moment, we'll be creating a palette with custom spot colors that we can use for VDP print jobs. But it's important to know that each custom color must be renamed to start with VDP underscore. The name of the color must also be identical with the column names in our data source. So for example, if I add a field for the name here, I will need an outline color called VDP underscore team name. And in my Excel spreadsheet, the column containing the names should also have the column heading VDP underscore team name. The reason for this is that once sent to the software RIP, the printer knows where to grab the data from to fill a specific field. Step 2. Creating a customized spot color palette for variable data print jobs. The next step is to create custom spot colors that we can use to outline our data fields. Open the palettes docker. Click on the plus sign at the bottom of the panel and choose New Empty Color Palette. Give the palette a name. In this case, I'm going to call it VDP Spot Palette. Use the eyedropper to add a color to the palette. Click on the flyout arrow and choose Edit Color. Under Selected Color, change the color name to VDP underscore team name. Treat as a spot color. Click Add Color to add a color for the team member. Select the color in the preview window and rename to VDP underscore team number and treat as a spot color. Click OK to save. Click on the flyout arrow again and choose Show Color Names. Now select the first data field and right-click on the team name color. The change of color will be reflected in the outline swatch on the status bar. Repeat with the team number field. I've just gone ahead and added extra colors to my VDP spot palette, so that I have colors ready for any type of variable print job that might land on my table. In this example, I have a contract to produce ID cards. The company has sent me an Excel spreadsheet with the employee names, job titles, and employee number. And I also received photos of the coworkers. I've already created the data fields, now I just need to assign the correct VDP colors to the outlines. Finally, I just checked the spreadsheet to make sure the column header names are identical to my outline color names. Note that the exact path of the images must be entered into the spreadsheet for the print merge to work. I'm now ready to export my ID card as a PDF or EPS file. I have now loaded my PDF file into Roland VersaWorks Dual Rip. I click on Settings and then on Variable Data. I check the Enable Variable Data Printing box. I point to my data source file. I now need to format my text objects. If you think that some text might not fit into the designated containers, activate auto sizing. Apply any other layout settings as needed. To finish off our tutorial, let's just take a look at two more examples of VDP files. The first is really simple, just a template for engraved inventory labels for machines. In this case, we just have a series of sequential numbers. And our RIP looks like this. In our final example, I have price labels to print for a supermarket, so I'll need to include barcodes. Barcode fonts are already installed. Here, I'm reformatting this column using a barcode font. Using variable data print can considerably speed up your workflow, allowing you to produce personalized prints efficiently and on a large scale.